It's 1965 in an alternate reality. The world is irreversibly altered and desolate after a nuclear extinction-level event. Cities are reduced to ruins, and the once thunderous battlegrounds are now silent. Amid this devastation, armored vehicles and tanks on both sides lay in ruins, now mere ashes and ghosts of what they once were. There is, however, one seemingly unaffected survivor, the Soviet Union's Object 279. Born in the secretive halls of the Kirov plant in Leningrad, this creation, weighing 60 tons and armed with a powerful 130mm main gun, Object 279 was the brainchild of an elite team of engineers that dreamed of a tank that could endure the inconceivable, one that could persevere in the face of ultimate destruction. Encased within its unique oval-shaped hull, the crew inside remained shielded, perhaps some of the last men in the world. As Object 279, with its unparalleled four-track design, traverses the treacherous terrains that now define this new world, it moves effortlessly through the remnants of blasted forests and over fields, navigating obstacles that would have halted any other tank. The Cold War-era developments in the armored warfare race led to some of history's most impressive tank designs. But none was more impressive than Object 279. In the late 1950s, as the conflict reached a fever pitch, the Soviet Union, seeking to gain an edge over their American counterparts, embarked on a mission to create a vehicle unlike any other. To them, it was necessary to create a special machine that could protect, fire, attack, and advance in the apocalyptic conditions of a post-nuclear battlefield. And so, in early 1956, the Soviet Union's chief main armor directorate of the Ministry of Defense presented tactical and technical requirements for a new generation heavy tank with a weight limit of 60 tons and an indispensable main armament of a 130mm gun. While there were already some available contemporary Soviet heavy tanks like the IS-2, IS-3, IS-4, and T-10, these vehicles were either too old, pricey, vulnerable, or underperforming to lead the Red Army into nuclear war. Following this, three vehicles were presented from various tank plants: Object 277, Object 770, and Object 279. While the first two were follow-ups to already available models, the latter was a radically different design, something nobody had ever attempted to do before or since. After a successful on-paper design drafted by an elite team of engineers at the Kirov plant in the capital of Leningrad, now St. Petersburg, work started the following year of the most unusual and daring project in the history of the world tank industry. By 1959, the prototype of the strangest tank ever made was finally ready. The brainchild of engineer L.S. Troyanov, a renowned Soviet creator, lauded for the development of the IS-4, Object 279 was a heavy tank meant to wage war on the European countryside battlefield in the impending World War III scenario. This track weapon was specifically made to resist and withstand a powerful and devastating nuclear attack, and the design was nothing short of radical. Powered by a 16-cylinder, 1,000-horsepower V2 diesel engine, the tank could reach speeds of up to 34 miles per hour, and its range, with a single refueling, was 186 miles. In comparison, the contemporary T-10 had a speed of 26 miles per hour and an operational range of 150 miles. At the heart of its offensive capabilities was a powerful 130mm M65 rifled gun that could fire armor-piercing and discard sabot rounds at a rate of 5 to 7 rounds a minute. The tank also featured a 14.5mm KPVT heavy machine gun as a secondary weapon, effective against infantry and lighter vehicles. To aid in targeting, Object 279 was equipped with an optical and radar rangefinder, an automatic guidance system, and night sight with an infrared searchlight for accurate firing in low light conditions. While these are commonplace in vehicles today, in the 1950s, they were nothing short of state-of-the-art. Manning this metal 60-ton behemoth was a crew of four: a tank commander, gunner, loader, and driver. Inside was a heating and cooling system for the crew, as well as biological, nuclear, radiological, and chemical protection. But there were two major things that truly set this tank apart. The most striking and distinctive feature of Object 279 was its elliptical, egg-shaped hull. But this was not just an aesthetic decision. Reflecting the belief among early Cold War planners that World War III would be a nuclear affair, this flying saucer on treads was intended to provide structural strength against shockwaves from nuclear blasts, keeping it from flipping over. Object 279's oval hull was common to Western experimental designs of the 1950s and 60s, but it was this prototype that brought it to perfection. The elliptical form was also beneficial in deflecting anti-tank and shaped charge ammunition. Object 279's armor was equally impressive. Frontal armor protection was as thick as 11 inches, while its contemporary, the American M60, was closer to only 6 inches. Moving this Leviathan was no simple task. Heavy tanks were traditionally cumbersome vehicles, better suited to flat, simple terrain, slowly lumbering around and providing long-range fire support to medium tanks. This led to a rarely seen tracking system. But Object 279 was optimized for moving more quickly across rough terrain, with not two, but four sets of tracks, equally spaced under the hull, combined to operate as pairs. This unique track footprint provided a ground pressure of around 8.5 pounds per square inch, which allowed the Soviet model to move without difficulty over swampy, soft ground or across tree stumps, snow, and reportedly even anti-tank obstacles like Czech hedgehogs. With the model finished by 1959, it was time to test its resistance to nuclear weapons. Object 279 was subjected to a series of secretive tests in various extreme conditions. First, to measure the effectiveness of its thick armor, the Soviet tank was exposed to sub-zero temperatures and later high altitudes. The model was also exposed to higher than normal radiation levels to try out its filtration systems. But the most impressive test was that the strangely shaped tank survived a simulated nuclear attack without significant damage. While Object 279 managed to pass nearly every trial, the chassis had several serious shortcomings. According to old Soviet documents now published on Russian websites, its adopted radical design had low agility and reduced efficiency when passing marshy terrain. Its operation required complex, expensive repair and maintenance and labor-intensive manufacturing. It also seemed that the tank's mere size also posed a problem, but calculations deemed reducing the overall height of the tank to be impossible. But while Object 279 just might have shrugged off a full-blown nuclear attack, no amount of armor nor egg-shaped hulls could protect it from Soviet politics. By the time the finished Object 279 was being tested, the Soviet Union had rapidly begun to relegate any remaining heavy tank units to reserves or even full decommissioning. Rather than relying on heavier models, the Red Army shifted its focus to more nimble and quicker medium tanks. This move saw the rise of the now famous T-54-55 and T-62, and eventually the adoption of main battle tanks, beginning with the T-64. This model is still a key component in the frontline arsenal of Russian forces. These MBTs provided a harmonious combination of firepower, defense, and maneuverability. They were designed to lead a new strategy of swift-moving integrated arms units, where tanks were supported by infantry transported in armored personnel carriers. With this, heavy tanks started to look like throwbacks to a different and now bygone era of warfare. By 1959, the same year it was finished, the writing was already on the wall for Object 279. In the late 1950s, Soviet Premier Nikita Khrushchev also had his own vision of what a potential Third World War would look like. According to the leader, rather than a replay of the previous war, in this new conflict, nuclear bombs and high-tech weapons, such as anti-tank missiles, would dominate the battlefield, not larger-than-life tanks. On July 22, 1960, during a presentation of new military equipment at the Kapustin Yar training area in Astrakhan Oblast, Khrushchev declared a ban on tanks exceeding 37 tons. This decision effectively terminated the entire Soviet heavy tank program, including the development of Object 279. With this, the tank, ready for nuclear war, was sent to the Armored Vehicles Museum instead. Some say three were finished, while other sources say only a single unit was built. But despite never receiving a formal place in the troops, Object 279 remained the most powerful tank in the world for a long time, until the appearance of the T-80U in the mid-1980s. Object 279's capacity to endure extreme conditions has established it as one of the most emblematic tanks of the Cold War period and a point of national pride for Russia. In 2022, a video from the Kubinka Tank Museum, just outside Moscow, shows Object 279 moving along the terrain. With the diesel engine roaring and a cloud of smoke around it, the Flying Saucer four-track tank with a red and camo paint job is seen ferrying forward, bringing Cold War-era feelings back again. Although information about the duration and specifics of this restoration is unclear, mirroring the obscure development and particulars of the tank itself, most accounts suggest that this is the only remaining Object 279 tank in existence.